Hello, my dolls, and welcome to the very first of a scale cycle play along. Something kind of different. Now, in the description below, I'm going to put a timestamp for when the play along portion happens if you're revisiting this video and want to skip ahead of this intro. But you should watch the intro because I'm going to tell you to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to show your support for all of these cello tip resources. So this exercise for beginner and intermediate players covering 1 to 2 octaves is inspired by a scale cycle exercise from my mentor, Peter Howard. I studied with him for 2 summers and it completely changed my life. I actually did a vlog telling that story, so you guys can check that out. But I wanted to take this exercise I learned from him. I wanted to make kind of a modified version for cellists who are just starting out that does not go beyond 3 sharps or 3 flats. I really think it's gonna help you learn your scales, memorize your fingerings, and really get a handle on bow distribution. So for this beginner version, we are gonna be starting with C major because it starts with your lowest string, and we are going to be changing to the next scale based off of the musical alphabet. So after C comes D major, then you have E flat major, and so on and so forth. So here are the bowing patterns. Round 1, slurring half note pairs, repeating each note as we change the bow. Then quarter notes in slurred groups of 4, no vibrato. Then slurred groups of 4 with vibrato. If you don't know vibrato yet, just stay no vibrato the whole time. Then slurred 8th notes, changing bow at the octave and repeating the start of the new octave. Then slurred 8th notes, but changing the bow on the octave so you won't be repeating. After that, slurred 8th notes in 4 beat patterns. After that, it will be 16th notes, changing bow again and repeating the octave. Then 16th notes, changing bow at the octave and not repeating the top note. Then bow conservation exercise, you are going to slur the whole 2 octaves, 1 bow of 16th notes, and you're going to change bow on the repeated top note and come back down the scale. And the very last variations, you do not need the metronome. We are going to play as fast as you can, all the way up on 1 bow, and then all the way down on an up bow. You want to maintain an even tone, even though your left hand is going crazy. And then last but not least, 1 super long down bow, and you're going to make it all the way up and all the way down. If it just sounds like a mess of notes and you have no idea what just happened, you need to do it a little slower. I've done this exercise for years, so don't try to match my speed. Go as fast as you are able to, and you still keep an even, consistent tone. So, enough yapping. Let's get to the play along with the scale cycle.
Thank you.
Did you make it? I bet you did. And you know what? If it was tricky, made some mistakes along the way, or got lost, don't worry about it. I had to do this for a really long time before I could even go beyond starting with C major. But I really hope you dolls enjoyed this play along. Let me know in the comments below if you like this format of doing a play along with Chelly and I. Maybe we'll do some more in the future. Once again, I'm the Cello Doll, and you can find me on Facebook, Instagram, and of course here on YouTube. Please subscribe to the channel. Thank you all so much for watching, and we'll see you next time. Bye!